phrases with it. There might be something there.
I'm all for it. Like space. Kind of like brie and chutney.
That's a good combo.
My name is Félix Lajeunesse. I'm the co-founder, chief creative officer at Felix and Paul Studios. I'm also the director of Space Explorers, the ISS Experience, a project that we filmed in space over a few years with David and his colleagues. And today we're here at the Canadian Space Agency.
Hello, my name is David Saint-Jacques. I'm an astronaut with the Canadian Space Agency, and I was also a cameraman, soundman, actor, scriptwriter for your project. One day it starts to appear in these generic week look ahead emails that there's going to be this camera flown to space station coming on a SpaceX cargo vehicle. I remember that day. It was a special moment for me because I thought, wow, that's this project from Montreal, from my hometown. I better make sure this works. I remember opening it and I recognize it from being shown the camera a long time before. And then we started this process.
Hey, I'm Anne McLean, and I'm on serial number 1001 for the audio recorder, and this is my first astronaut log event, so. So there's the sync up.
It was a lot of back and forth. It's a bit of a prototype. We never got training on the ground for it, and we were welcome to provide ideas because we know the place. You have to understand that the life of a crew member during a mission is, it's very busy, obviously, but it's you're in a very operational mindset. If you're repairing a spacesuit and then you have 10 minutes to do a video recording, and the next thing you do, you're doing a science experiment, you're never gonna be able to switch minds. So for such long periods of filming where it's very interpersonal, we always try to do it at the end of the week, or at least at the end of the day, to give yourself a chance to get into that storytelling frame of mind.
And the sooner you can remap everything to be 3D, the quicker you'll be able to move through here.
From a cinematographic standpoint, here on Earth, we are used to thinking about the camera as an item that's going to be positioned relative to the floor. So we read possibilities of filming in spaces in one axis, which is the axis of gravity. But when you enter into an environment of microgravity, anything can become the base for a camera. And that changes literally how you read a room. So you might only have 6 or 7 modules that you can film into, but each of those modules have 4 different perspectives. So already, it quadruples the possibilities.
And there's something actually peculiar about this camera. Normally when we film, everybody knows that the camera's pointing there. People can do whatever they want off stage. When you put the camera on, the whole station is on stage.
Was it a source of worry at the beginning? Because this camera sees everything. Was there like a sense of, oh my God, we're being looked at from all angle? Or was it like seen as, okay, it's 360 cinema? What was the reaction?
It's like hosting visitors at your place. If they're gonna go only in the kitchen, well, you just clean the kitchen. But if you're gonna show them the whole house, then you gotta clean the whole house a little bit. So in normal life, I'm not someone that keeps a diary. You know, I talk to my wife, to my friends about my life, and my diary is in their head. And so for me, that was similar, using the Z-Cam. It was always positioned where someone's head would be, so it finally felt like you were talking to someone. And the things that I wanted to share, the dearest treasure that I brought back from my trip to space is the perspective on our planet. That perspective on the human condition in the middle of the cosmos, I think it's a very powerful tool to address these modern ailments, environmental concerns, geopolitical mayhem, all that in a way can benefit from a little bit of perspective. And so I thought any outreach is good, but this is a particularly powerful one. 360 degree, immersive, you're there. Look around, there you are. Mm-hmm. On the space station, this is what the Earth looks like. Just that, unsaid, is very powerful.
Merci pour ton temps, merci pour ta générosité.
Bon voyage. On va sûrement savoir, c'est un petit monde.
C'est un petit monde. Au revoir ici, Yacine. Merci pour tout.